Good morning, Girl Scouts. All right, this is Katie from Cincinnati. Hey, Girl Scouts, this is Katie from Cincinnati. I am here to go over the Daisy What Robots Do badge with you all. So I just want to take a second before we get started, allow some time for other people to join us today. So while you're logging on, if you can just tell us in the comments who you are, where you are watching from, and tell me a little bit maybe about a robot that you have maybe seen either in real life or on TV, or maybe one that you've used before. Maybe you've actually used a robot. So while you're commenting here, I will tell you one that I have used before. So I have actually used a robotic vacuum cleaner, which I think is really super cool because vacuuming is not the most exciting task in the world. And that is one way that robots can actually make our lives a little bit easier and can allow us to focus on other things that maybe we're more interested in doing or just give us more time to do more things in the day because we are always really busy. So a robotic vacuum cleaner is really cool because you can program it to get to know your house, and it actually will clean your house. It'll vacuum, and it'll know to go around your stairs, and it'll know to go around like your furniture and things like that. So that is pretty cool. So just let us know as you're logging on, like I said, who you are, where you're from, and about a robot maybe that you've used or seen either in real life or maybe something you have seen on TV. All right, so looks like we've got a few people joining us this morning. Feel free to comment and we'll just get started right now. So looks like Marissa says she needs a robotic vacuum. Mine is currently broken, but they are pretty cool. So we are going to go over the Daisy What Robots Do badge. So this is actually part of a series of badges for robotics, and this is the first of three. So, looks like we've got Tegan, who's from Toledo, Ohio, and Tegan has seen a robot camera. That's really cool. I am sure that that is awesome. Welcome, Tegan. So the steps to this badge are to learn what robots are. The second step is to learn what robots do. And then the third step is to team up and design your own idea for a robot. All right, it looks like Jocelyn, who is from Little Egg Harbor, New Jersey. I think I've seen you on a few of our lives before. I just love the name of that town. It sounds great. Jocelyn says they need help with the robot vacuum for the pool. Oh yeah, I bet a robotic vacuum for a pool would be awesome. I'm not sure if that exists because I don't actually have a swimming pool, but that would be really cool and super helpful. All right, Eleanor from Beaver Creek, she has used a Lego robot with her brothers. That's awesome. All right, and we'll do one more. So Jenna from Michigan has seen a robot at a Lego competition last year that moves blocks into a container. That's awesome. So as you can see, just from the few comments here, there's a bunch of different things that robots can do to help make our lives a little easier and do all sorts of cool things. And robots have been around for a little while, but, you know, we're just kind of diving into what all the possibilities of what robots can do are. So scientists are working every single day to find new ways that robots can make our lives both safer and easier. So what is a robot? So that's a word that we hear and see all the time. There are tons and tons of movies out there and TV shows that talk about robots and all the crazy possibilities that could happen with robots. But what actually is it? So a robot is a machine that runs automatically. That's all it is. So we as humans, have to give the robot instructions to follow so that it can do a job. And so typically the reason that we make robots is so that they can either make our lives easier or possibly even safer. We'll have a ton of examples of how robots can make our lives safer and easier throughout this little workshop that we're doing today. So, but remember that robots can only do what humans tell them to do. So that means that humans have to program a robot. And a program is just a set of instructions. But what makes it different is that they're actually written into a different language, which is a coding language that robots can actually understand. And that set of instructions is called an algorithm. And if you've actually been watching, I know there's a few of you, few familiar names that I'm seeing on here that have followed along with some of the cybersecurity badge workshops that I've done in the last few weeks. We've heard the term algorithm before. An algorithm is just a set of instructions. I know that's a really big word, but it's the same thing as a set of instructions, just like you would follow a recipe that tells you how to make bread or cake or something like that. It's also similar to when somebody gives you directions to their house. It's a set of instructions that you have to follow to get the desired outcomes. So, and like I said, that those algorithms are written into a different coding language. And we have to learn that to be able to program a robot to do what we want it to do. So computer scientists and robotics engineers are doing these kinds of things all the time to develop all kinds of different robots. So sometimes if we write a code wrong, or maybe we forget a letter or a number or something, then that creates what is called a bug. And you've probably heard something similar to like your computer having a bug or a virus or something like that. And really that just means that the code was written incorrectly. So then the robot isn't able to understand what we are wanting it to do. And then what we have to do is called debugging the robot, which just means fixing the code to the language that the robot can understand. Looks like we've got a few comments coming in here. So someone says that they would love a robotic vacuum. Definitely a good thing to have. And then it looks like Grace from Georgia wants a robot to help clean her room. And that is a great example of how robots could easily help make our lives just a little bit easier and do something that we don't really want to do. So great suggestion. All right, so for step two, we're going to talk about all kinds of different things that robots can do. And robots can do so many different things that we don't even have time to talk about all of them today. And probably some of them are things that like are beyond even what I could understand, because there's so many different things that scientists have figured out that robots can do to help us. So like I said before, typically robots are created to make our lives easier, either doing tasks that humans find boring or just don't want to do. Like somebody mentioned having one that cleans their room. Great example. So if you can think of any other examples of things that that robots could do to make your life easier, put that in the comments and I'll share it. I bet you guys can come up with a ton of great ideas for how robots could make your life easier. But another way that robots can help us is to actually make us safer. And if you have any ideas for how robots can make you safer, definitely put those in the comments too. And while you're doing that, I've got a couple of suggestions that I came up with to help us out. So one type of robot that can actually, it can kind of do both, maybe do something that we don't necessarily always want to do and also can make us safer, is self-driving cars. So a self-driving car, actually, I think it already exists, but I would bet that none of us who are watching here today probably have one of those because they're pretty new technology, and I think they're still trying to figure out how to make them as safe as possible. But you know, I have a regular car, as I'm sure most of our families do. And when I get into my car, I need to turn it on. I have to, you know, put the key in the ignition and turn it on. I have to put it in drive. I have to press the gas when I want it to go. I have to push the brakes if I want it to stop. And I also have to know in my head where I want to go, and I need to know the directions. Or I need to use my map or maybe my phone that has maps on it to help me get where I want to go. The car can't just figure it out and take me where I want to go. However, self-driving cars use robotics to actually help us drive. So the robot can actually take directions and take us from point A to point B, and it would know when to stop because it has sensors on it that can sense that there's a stoplight. They know when there's stop signs. They know when there is a car stopping in front of it so that it can stop with enough space. And you know, we're not, as humans, we're not perfect drivers, but if robotics can progress enough to make cars even safer than human drivers, then that's a way that that we can make our lives way safer and also easier because, you know, a lot of us like to drive, but not everybody does, and sometimes you just don't want to drive. All right, do we, it looks like we've got a couple comments coming in. So Marissa says that she would love a robot that could fold laundry and put it back in the closet. That would be awesome. I am sure that a robotics engineer could come up with something like that. That would be pretty cool. Another couple examples are firefighting. So, firefighting is definitely something that can pose a threat to humans, and we are so lucky to have so many great firefighters out there that have learned how to put out a fire when they happen accidentally. But those firefighters, are really brave to have to go in and fight that fire. But if we can also use robotics to help us fight those fires, it can actually make us a lot safer so that firefighters don't have to put themselves in as much danger. Looks like we've got another comment coming in. Eleanor would like a robot that could play music and dance with her. That is such a great idea, Eleanor. I love that. So that is one way that robots can definitely make our lives easier and can be made for entertainment too. And that is something too that I forgot to mention. So thank you, Eleanor, is that robots can actually can be for entertainment too. So they can help us with all kinds of different things. So I'm sure that there are toys out there that are made with robotics that maybe can learn how to like repeat what you're saying and things like that. So Jocelyn says that when she drives in her friend's Tesla, it beeps when a car gets too close. Well, that is really cool. So that is totally the same thing as robotics because it has a sensor that can tell when another car is getting too close to us because, you know, we as humans, maybe we don't see that car or, you know, we don't have sensors to see what's necessarily coming behind us if we're in a car. So that is a great suggestion and a great idea. So thank you. All right. So let's move on. Oh, so one more example that I came up with too is space exploration. So space exploration is a great way that we can use robotics because actually exploring space does have some dangers to it. So if you guys have ever heard of the Mars rover, that is a robot that we have actually, and actually there's been several robots that we have sent to Mars, which is really, really far away from Earth. So when we send humans, you know, maybe to the moon or just out to the space station, that's not actually that far, and it's maybe a little less dangerous than trying to go all the way to a different planet. So Mars is really, really far away. And if we were to send humans, we don't really know what could happen. So not to say that we couldn't figure out how to send humans one day, but it's definitely safer to send robots, because what if the spaceship breaks down? Then it would take a really long time to send another spaceship to get the supplies and all the mechanics needed to repair it and bring it home. So, and there's all sorts of things that could happen in space. So that is one real life example of how robots can make humans safer and do the things that we want it to do. All right, so it looks like we've got a couple more comments here. So it looks like Grayson watched Star Wars and there were robots in that movie. Yes, that is a great example. And they did what people said for them to do. So that is a great example. And that is part of how robotics technology is developing, so that humans could actually communicate and tell a robot what to do. So if you have one of those home systems where you can tell it to, I forget what they're called, but tell it to play music, or you can tell it to order you something, or things like that, that's definitely using robotics technology. So that is great. And I'm sure some of that was actually even inspired by the people who made movies like Star Wars, because back when those first movies were created, robotics technology was not as advanced as it is today. So that is a really great, great example. All right, so we're gonna move on to step three. So we've completed steps one and two so far. So now that we kind of know a little bit more about what robots are and what robots do, now we can come up with our own idea for a robot. So you guys have already come up with some great ideas, and then we're gonna actually kind of design it out. So there are just three kind of essential pieces of a robot that you'll want to think about when you're designing your robot. So every robot needs to have a brain, which is not the same thing as a human brain, but it's a controller that is part of the robot that takes direction from a program. So it's really similar to a human brain, but it is more like a computer. So it also needs to have a body. So that is the mechanical parts, such as wheels, gears, motors, things like that, that make up the body of the robot. And the third essential piece of a robot is sensors. So sensors are devices that help robots take in information from the world around them. So we talked about how some cars actually have sensors in them to sense if there's another car getting too close to it. Well, that is exactly what a sensor is. So those are the three main parts. And sensors are really just like our eyes and our ears and our nose. We as humans have sensors that kind of help us navigate the world around us. So if I see something dangerous ahead, I can stop and go the other way. Or if I hear something loud, maybe I hear my smoke alarm, if there's a fire, so I know to get out of my house, those kinds of things. So we use our senses every day, and robots do that too. All right, so like I said, robots can look all sorts of different ways. So they can be made out of all sorts of different materials, and it really just depends what you want to do. And this is the part of the badge where you get to use your imagination. So robots can be made out of wood, paper, metal, all sorts of things, and they can be all sorts of shapes and sizes. All right, so I'm going to show you one idea that I have for a robot that would really help me make my life a little easier. So I came up with a dog walking robot. So my robot is made out of metal because when this is outside, I don't want it to break easily. So I felt like metal would be the best thing that it could be made out of. So like if it's raining, then the parts inside of it won't get damaged. And then maybe if my dog tries to like chew on it, then it's a little bit sturdier. So that's why I chose metal. So this is a dog walking robot. So, you know, we get a lot of rain here in Ohio. And some days, you know, I come home from work and I'm really exhausted. And my dog needs a lot of exercise. I don't know about you guys, if you guys have dogs at home, but sometimes there are just days where I don't really feel like taking my dog on a walk, but he still needs it, and so I still have to do it. But if I had a robot that I could program to tell the robot how to walk my dog, my life would be a little bit easier on some days. Although some days I do like taking my dog on a walk, so it's not every day that I would want to use this. Okay, so if you can see here, I'll just kind of put it up a little closer. So the robot has a few different sensors on it. So it has eyes that can sense if maybe there's a stop sign and the robot needs to stop. It also has sensors on the arm. So, you know, I have a puppy, so he is pretty young, and he likes to just run forward really, really fast. And, you know, I'm trying to train my dog not to do that, and I want my dog walker robot to do the same exact thing. So when my dog kind of is going too fast and he's kind of running way ahead, then this has a sensor on it so that it can stop my dog from going all over the place. And that's what the arm can do. It also has wheels at the bottom here that can make it move, but they can also stop when we need to stop, because my dog doesn't know when there's a stop sign or a stoplight, or maybe there's a car in our way, but the robot knows and can help keep my dog safe. And then also, like I said, I'm still training my dog, so we need to be able to give our dogs commands. Some examples might be, you know, like if my dog was doing a really good job of pacing itself, my robot could say, good job, good boy, or it could say stop, or it could say wait, all the things that I train my dog to do, so it can kind of help reinforce the training for my dog. So this robot is taking in information from the world around it with those sensors, and then that information goes to the brain and can help control the walk so that we're not just running all around the neighborhood going crazy. So that is my dog walking robot, and I am so excited to see everything that you all create, because I know that you have amazing imaginations that will come up with some really awesome ideas. And it looks like Jocelyn says that she would use that robot when it's raining. Well, I bet a lot of people would like to use that. And so it's good to hear that, Jocelyn, that you would use my robot. So I will definitely look into how we can make that happen. So, all right. So that is my idea for a design. And I do want to mention too that even though we didn't make a robot today, we did a really important step in the design process, which is using our imagination to come up with an idea. And scientists and engineers have to do this all the time. They have to design things and draw out what they envision, and then also the set of instructions. So these are some of the instructions that I wrote down for what the dog walking robot could do. So, and I already told you what those are, but it's really important that we do that so we organize our thoughts and get our imagination out there before we start building. And that's a very important step. And really also sharing that with others so that they can give you ideas and feedback so that you can improve your design. And so once you get to build it, then you can test it and make it even better. And those are really important parts of the engineering process. So, now that you guys know how to do that, you can go ahead and create your own and then send us pictures of what you create. We would absolutely love to see that. So with that, we have finished the Daisy What Robots Do badge. So just to recap what we've done today. So we have done all three steps. So the first step was learning what robots are. The second step was learning what robots do. And the third step is to design your own idea for a robot. So Thank you so much for watching today. And if you are not a Girl Scout, but you have enjoyed watching our videos and you want to learn how to join a troop near you, you can go to girlscouts.org/join. And then if you want to see our next video, we have another one coming up. One of our program team leads, Megan, is doing the Space Science Researcher Badge for Brownies at 2 p.m. So we hope to see you there. And again, thank you so much for watching and joining me for this badge workshop. And I hope you all have a great day. So peace out, Girl Scouts.